Hello friends, I am Dr. Naveneet Baveja, professor in MBA department of IIMT College of Engineering. Today I'll be speaking to you on a very important topic, that is developing interpersonal skills. Now, within interpersonal skills, I would like to focus on how to hone up our assertiveness skills, right? So first, let's take a look at the types of interpersonal skills and what exactly are interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills are the qualities and behaviors that we exhibit when we are interacting with others, when we are communicating with others. The various types of interpersonal skills, I'm just focusing on a few, but there are many more. Very importantly, in the workplace, we need to exhibit emotional intelligence. Now, what exactly is emotional intelligence? We need to be firstly aware of our own emotions, understand our own emotions, and manage our own emotions. Similarly, the people we are interacting with, our team members, our colleagues, we need to be aware of and understand their emotions, and if possible, help them to control or manage their emotions. So this broadly is emotional intelligence. Right? The next one I talk about is communication. Communication here would involve verbal and non-verbal communication, and very importantly, active listening skills also. Please remember, there are techniques for honing up all these skills. But today I'll be focusing on the topic of assertiveness skills. Now, what exactly is assertiveness? Assertiveness. Now, if you take a look at this continuum, I have aggressiveness on one end and submissiveness on the other. Okay? Assertiveness is right in the middle, and it is considered to be a balanced response, which is said to be neither passive nor aggressive, with complete self-confidence playing an important part. So, we need to be somewhere in the middle, being neither aggressive nor submissive. We need to make sure that we are putting our point across very clearly, very calmly, but not backing down even in the face of opposition. So that is what we mean when we say assertiveness. Now, a very important question is that why do we need to hone up our assertiveness skills? In order to firstly improve our self-esteem and also to increase our personal confidence. All these go a long way in maintaining workplace harmony, in building up teamwork. Teamwork is also a very important interpersonal skill that we talk about. Then I'll come back to assertiveness again. Let me just take you through the remaining interpersonal skills. Negotiation, we all hear of so often. Negotiation and even conflict resolution. This is something which is essential for any manager in today's day and world. Positivity. It is something which we all struggle with each day. Maintaining a positive demeanor for ourselves, our families, and maintaining a positive front for our team members is a challenge for most of us today, but this is also one of the most important aspects of our everyday work life, and this is a gift I feel that we give to maintaining a culture in an organization that we each one of us can be positive and encourage others to remain positive also. Then we talk about empathy, which has undertones of how to understand and be compassionate towards the situations that others find themselves in. So being empathetic is also a skill which can be picked up. All these are skills, and any good training and development manager will have techniques by which they can help you and maintain or pick up skills which are through some techniques, through exercises on a periodic basis, which are frequently repeated. These are some interpersonal skills which can be improved. Now, back to assertiveness. There are some techniques which we can use for honing up our interpersonal skills, that is specifically assertiveness. The first technique I talk about is something called fogging, F-O-G-G-I-N-G. In this, if we are dealing with manipulative or aggressive behavior, then what to do? How to respond, right? So we can cultivate our responses, we can cultivate a habit to respond in an assertive fashion whenever we are dealing with manipulative behavior, which, as we all know, we deal with it so often, sometimes multiple times in a day. Whenever you are confronted by such a person, you need to maintain a demeanor by which you give a calm, minimal response and at the same time agreeing with the truth. Let's say you have reached late for a meeting and your senior is confronting you in a loud voice by saying that, why are you late? How dare you not inform me? So your response would be that, yes, I'm sorry, I am late. I agree with you that this is not acceptable behavior. But your tone of voice, your overall mannerisms, they need to be very, 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 very calm. It is as if you are absorbing the other person's aggressive behavior, manipulative behavior into a fog, which is your passive, calm response. So this is one technique, fogging. It can be better explained through role plays or exercises, but I'm simply trying to introduce the concept here. The second technique, very effective technique, is the technique of broken record. Again, it is characterized by controlling our own response, our own behavior, whenever we are confronted with somebody who is not receptive to what we are trying to say. So we need to be very calm, we need to be very persistent. Again, being assertive does not mean that you are being passive, not at all. On the other hand, you are repeating what you want without raising your voice, without changing your tone, right? And very importantly, without becoming angry. Especially in situations where, for example, you need to exchange a product. It's a faulty product, you want to go and exchange it to a shopkeeper. He is saying something from his viewpoint and he's saying that, look, this cannot be changed. But rather than getting angry with him or, arguing with him, we need to persistently repeat and with a calm demeanor. Once you have mastered this technique, you will find that it will become a habit and your growing success as far as your own assertiveness is concerned, once you taste that success, it is something which will empower you a lot and will make you even a better team player than what we might be today. Thank you.